Hi guys, welcome back. Today we are going to see how to calculate grades based on the student marks and class grade average using Python. Let's get over to the collab. So the steps we are going to approach to solve this code are: given different score marks of students, we need to find grades. The test score is based on assignments. So the test score is based on assignments and tests and lab exams. So, and each of this has certain weightage. The following weightages are 10% for the assignments. So 10% for the assignments. 1 minute. And 70% of marks scored from tests, and finally 20% of marks scored in lab works. So these are the weightages. For this, there are four assignments. So there are four assignments and two tests, and finally two lab exams. So after calculating the average of all students, we can assign grades based on their scores. So if a student gets the score greater than a score greater than or equal to 90, then the grade is A. If student scores greater than 80, then the grade will be B. So if the score is greater than or equal to 70, then the grade will be C. Following D. Else, if the score is less than 60, then the grade will be, if the grade less than 60, then the grade will be E. So like that, we assign the grades based on the student's average marks. And after getting average scores of all students, we can also calculate the entire class average by calculating sum of average scores of students divided by number of students, and we can assign grade as well for the whole class. Okay, let's begin with coding part by creating some student marks database. Like assume Jack is equal to, let's create dictionary to store the name and marks of the student. The full name of Jack is Jack Prost, and for the assignment he got 80, 50, 40, 20. So it's up to you. You can assume whatever you want. And for the test, let's assume 75, 75, because there are two tests. There are four assignments and two tests and two lab works. And for lab works, he might be get 78.20 or 77.20. Like this, let's create a dictionary for two more students. So I'm just copy and paste. I'm just going to do copy and paste. Two. And instead of Jack, let's assume the name is James and his full name is James Potter. And let's assume some marks: 82, 56, 44. Not 30. And for test, he got 80, 80. In lab work, he got 67.90, comma 78.72. So instead of James, you can call as Dylon. Like his full name is Dylon Rhodes. I just assumed these norms. I don't know about all these names. Sorry, persons. Let's assume some assignment marks like 77.82, 23.39, and for test, assume 78.77, and in lab exams, 80.80. So as of now, we created students' marks database in dictionary format. Now let's define the function to create the formula to get the average marks for individual student. Let's create function def get average marks. Get average marks the total sum is equal to sum of marks. So we know the formula of the average, that is total sum of all elements divided by the number of elements. So we calculated the sum of marks. Total sum is equal to float of total sum. I applied float on the total sum. This is up to you. Return total sum divided by length of marks. We know the formula of average, that is sum of elements by a length of elements. So we define the function to calculate the average. Now let's apply this function on assignment, test and lab marks of the individual student. Okay, let's define another function def calculate total average students here. We pass the student variable. Okay, let's calculate the average marks of the assignment, test and lab of every student. Assignment is equal to, we already created the function to calculate the average, just pass the, so this one, just pass the assignment marks into the get average function. Get average students assignment. So this step will calculate average assignment marks for the given student. Do the same for the test and lab marks. So test is equal to get average students of test. So this will calculate average test marks for the individual student. Lab is equal to get average. So this get average function applies the average function on the assignment, test and lab. Okay, students lab. So return return 0.1 into assignment. Plus 0.7 into test, comma, sorry, plus 0.2 into lab. We We already assumed the weightages for assignment, test and lab. There is 10% weightage for the assignment and 70% weightage for the test and 20% weightage for the lab exam. Okay. So after getting average of all the assignment, test and lab exams, it returns 0.1 into assignment plus 0.7 into test, nothing but 70% weightage of the test, and 0.2 into lab, that is 20%. Okay. So by using these two functions, we can calculate the average of individual students. Now let's define another function to assign grades for every student based on their average score. So DEF assign letter grade score if, in case if score greater than or equal to 90, then return, we already know that. So if score is greater than or equal to 90, then the grade will be A, and the score is greater than or equal to 80, then the score will be then the grade will be B. Okay, return A. If score greater than or equal to 80, return B. If score greater than or equal to 70, return C. If score greater than or equal to 60, return D. Else return E. So for now, we defined functions to get the average marks of the students and to assign the grade. But now I want total class average and grade of the whole class. Let's define one more function, DEF class average. Class average is a student list create an empty list now create an empty list to store the average marks of the students. Result list is equal to create an empty list. So for student in student list, for student in student list, student average. Now we are going to calculate the average marks of the every student. Okay, so to calculate the average of the whole class, we need to apply the formula like total sum of the students, average marks of students divided by the number of students. Okay, so student average, apply the calculate total average, so this one function, on every student and append those results, means average marks, to the empty list. Okay, don't worry, first apply the calculate total average of student, append those average of the individual student marks into this empty list. Okay, so result list dot append student average, return get average result list. Okay, so after calculating average marks of the individual student, apply get average function function on the return list and returns the average, because this function applies, this getAverage function applies the average formula on this return list. Okay. And now let's add all these, append all these three variable names into a list, because we can easily iterate and we can print the average marks of every student, and we can also print grade as well. Okay, students is equal to we created Jack, James and Dylan. Jack, James and Dylan. So for I in students, it's nothing but for student in students, for a single student in students, print a name of the student, I of name, because this I is the variable name. We know how to access the key values in the dictionary, I of name. So this one, I of name. Let's print some operators to give some partition between the output lines, like print, like print average marks of, this is a string format, is modulus. So this is just a string format. Here it replaces with I of name, comma, calculate total average of I. So I is nothing but a student. Okay, I is nothing but student. Print. Now we are going to display grade as well. Grade of string format is something but, so grade of the this S is assumes a name of the student. Grade of the name of the student is modulus S, modulus I of name, comma, assign letter grade, calculate total average of I. Here first it calculates the total average of the marks of the individual student, and it assigns the grade based on the student marks. Okay, don't confuse here. Print to give some partition. Now let's print average of whole class. Print class average of, class average is modulus S, modulus class AV. So before printing this, we need to assign some variable. Class AV is equal to class average is students. Okay, so we already created to calculate the whole average marks of the class. Ready? Print grade of the whole class is dealers S. So instead of S, it's going to be print as a letter grade class AV. Okay, so this class AV contains the average marks of the total class. Okay, let's run this. We got one error. This total sum. Okay, great, we got the output. So the average marks of Jake Forrest is 72.79 and his grade is C. So we know that if a score is greater than or equal to 70, then the grade will be C. And the average marks of James Potter is 75 and he got a grade C. And for the Dylan, he got 75.775 and he also got C. You can see a class average is 72.79 and the grade of the whole class is C. Okay guys, I hope you can understand whatever we discussed now. Thank you, keep on practice, bye bye.